Live, local breaking news. This is WYFF News 4 at 6 in high definition.
Good evening, everybody. I'm Michael Cogdell.
And I'm Carol Goldsmith. We begin with a winter storm bringing more than snow to northeast Georgia and western North Carolina. First, a look from resortcams.com showing us Cataloochee and Maggie Valley, North Carolina. Forecasters say parts of the mountains could get up to 12 inches of snow.
Now, something a bit different. How's this for a view? Brasstown, Bald Mountain in northeast Georgia. And no, the camera is not broken. It is just that foggy. You can hardly see anything. And this tonight, too, wind advisories were issued after 10 homes and a daycare were damaged today. Chief Meteorologist John Sesrich is here. John, at one time we had more than 30 weather alerts on WYFF4.com, so how much more snow for the mountains?
As far as measurable snow, I think we're pretty much done with it, looks like Michael and Carol. The big concern really in the winter storm warning continues for the same areas in North Carolina, that especially the counties that border along Tennessee from now until 6 o'clock tomorrow morning, really because of blowing and drifting snow, thanks to those strong northwesterly winds gusting to 30 to 40 miles per hour, causing the blowing and drifting snow, and also really lowering the wind chills. Very, very cold outside, to say the least. So an additional maybe an inch or two possible, but the heaviest snowfall is over with. Buncombe County winter weather advisory continues from now until midnight tonight, and that's really because of those strong northwest winds blowing snow at times. You may see a couple of scattered flurries or snow showers, but really that's about it. But some spring-like weather is on the way. We'll talk more about that in detail a little bit later on. Now back to you, Carol.
Like to hear that. Thanks, John. The snow continues to fall, though, in parts of western North Carolina, and DOT crews are trying to stay a step ahead of the weather. News 4's Myra Ruiz is live and local in Weaverville. Myra, how are things there?
Well, Carol, I think a lot of people here are looking forward to hearing more about that spring weather that John just mentioned. But for now, things appear to be moving pretty smoothly. As you can see behind me, a lot of people probably heading back home from work, and DOT crews have been working hard to make sure the roads have been clear for this crowd. But meanwhile, throughout the day, it's been pretty hazy and foggy as it is now, and they've been dealing with a cold, damp, windy day.
That's one you need to write down.
They weren't in a classroom, but it was still a day of learning for the Hudgens children. For starters, snow plus no school equals sledding.
Oh, I was very happy because I don't really like school, and we don't really get this much snow.
All the snow that fell at the Hudgens home in Lester vanished by mid-morning, so the family headed out to Madison County.
It's a fun day for the kids, I know that's for sure. For me, usually I'm working.
Darren Hudgens has a roofing company, and it wasn't a great day to get anything done. But the workload for DOT crews was as heavy as expected. There was a constant stream of vehicles going in and out, loading up with a salt mixture to treat the roads.
You know, it's not uncommon for us to see snows this big and bigger in this area. The winds have been up. We've had a few trees down, and the power lines, you know, are usually a concern. But this year, the power company done an excellent job in clearing their right-of-ways.
Work crews spent the day clearing secondary roads and revisiting the interstate, but near the Tennessee line, travel at times was slower than normal due to slushy snow on the roads and foggy conditions.
The temperatures are dropping again, so, you know, this stuff's going to freeze back up.
A busy day in the snow for work and play.
They love it. They love it. And it kind of brings the kid out in us, parents.
Now, this is actually Weaverville, Michael Cogdell's hometown, and we did check in with his mom, who says that when he was a little boy, he loved playing in this stuff, and she has the pictures to prove it. Meantime, a lot of people here are waiting to find out if they will have to go back to school tomorrow. And of course, you can find the latest on our website, WYFF4.com. Maya Ruiz, WYFF News 4, live in Weaverville.
Right she is. That's what happens when you give a reporter your mother's phone number right there. The snow is making its presence felt up the coast and into the northeast tonight, covering roads, shutting down schools and more, knocking out the power as well. In the D.C. area for a little while, they saw near whiteout conditions today. More than a dozen congressional hearings had to be canceled. This snow in D.C. did turn to rain later there in the district, but parts of Virginia are bracing for the possibility of more than a foot of snow. Now, let's look at Pittsburgh, where homeowners used a break in the storm to dig out with the snow blowers. Forecasters predict 4 to 6 inches of snow for Pittsburgh proper. Let's see, forecasters, the snow has also forced some 3,600 flight cancellations from the Midwest and East Coast over the past 2 days. Now to the west, where things turned dangerous in the Chicago area. A roof collapsed under the weight of roughly 9 inches of snow there. And in Tinley Park, a school bus lost control and crashed into some apartments. A missing persons call quickly turned into a sex crime investigation. Adrian Caron is charged with criminal sexual conduct with a minor tonight. A mother who thought her daughter was missing found that the child had been with her tumbling instructor, who was Caron. Investigators say the girl told deputies that she and Caron had been kissing and touching, so her mother had her examined for sexual assault. Caron was questioned and charged, and the investigation carries on. Spartanburg County deputies say they arrested a cookie thief today, but these cookies won't fit in a jar. You may remember this case. Carrie Moving and Storage reported the theft of nearly $19,000 worth of Girl Scout cookies last week. We're told after the initial delivery for the season, the company did an inventory and found 450 cases of cookies all gone. Thin mints and shortbread. Investigators say this man stole them. They arrested Christopher Morton today. We're told he was a truck driver for Carrie. He has been fired since his arrest. Greenville County deputies say they found the cookies behind an abandoned business on Haywood Road. Investigators say Morton confessed to stealing them and disposing of the cases in Greenville.
Here in the upstate, there was a school bus crash involving children late this morning. We're told it happened at 11 in front of Fairview Garden Apartments on Williamston Road. Our cameras were unable to see any visible damage to the school bus. Officers say they're still trying to figure out if the bus was actually hit. However, we are told 9 children were taken to the ER as a precaution. Highway Patrol says a police officer who may have been responding to the wreck flipped his car on River Street. We're told the officer was trapped for a little while. Police say the officer was eventually freed from the wreck and taken to the hospital. Police tell us the officer was alert and responsive. We're told no one else was injured in that wreck.
Quite a haul at GSP. Kilos of cocaine, pounds of marijuana, and $142,000 all found in some carry-on bags. Authorities arrested these people in Greenville County: 39-year-old Shannon Davis, 30-year-old Makeisha Maddox, 50-year-old Billy Glenn, and 24-year-old Renee Wakefield. They're all charged with drug trafficking. We're told the arrests follow a 16-month investigation by the DEA. Deputies say in October of 2011, they arrested Tony Wakefield and seized 5 kilograms of cocaine and 53 pounds of marijuana. In that investigation, they identified James Snowden as head of the organization in Greenville. Investigators say he employed couriers to fly money to his drug sources in San Diego. Well, last February, the DEA seized that $142,000 from those carry-on bags. Shannon Davis and Makeisha Maddox were identified as part of the Snowden organization. He was arrested in November on a federal drug charge, and in all of this, more arrests are expected.
Starting next month, you will be allowed to take your pocket knife onto an airplane without fear of it being confiscated. On April 25th, the Transportation Security Administration will allow small pocket knives whose blades are 2.36 inches or shorter on commercial flights. Ski poles, hockey sticks, lacrosse sticks, billiard cues, golf clubs, and small novelty bats will also be allowed. The TSA says the rule changes will allow agents to focus on higher threat items that can cause harm. Yet some passengers we spoke to were amused by the changes because of things they've had confiscated in the past.
But the biggest thing is the nail clippers. You know, why in the world would I take a plane over with a set of nail clippers? And I've had 4 or 5 of those stolen.
Many pilots and flight attendants are opposed to allowing small knives on planes because box cutters were used by the 9/11 hijackers. Box cutters, by the way, are still banned on flights.